Live from Memorial Coliseum in Lexington, Kentucky, WKYT Sports presents the Kentucky Women's College Basketball Championship. This afternoon, the Kentucky Lady Cats take on the Hilltoppers of Western. Today's game is brought to you in part by Leroy's Jewelers, seven stores in the Bluegrass area. Southern Salads, they're the nearest thing to homemade. And the Courier Journal, courier journalism for those who want to know or know they need to.
Seven teams set out in quest of the Kentucky Women's Intercollegiate Tournament title on Friday, and now the contenders are down to just two, the Western Kentucky Lady Toppers and the University of Kentucky Lady Cats. Hello, everybody. I'm Denny Treese. With me is Sue Feimster, the Women's Athletic Director at the University of Kentucky. Sue, how about giving us a brief scouting report on both these teams?
Well, Denny, it's going to be a tough game tonight for both people. Kentucky's going to be trying to stop Brenda Chapman, who scored 61 points out of their team's 181 points that they've scored in the last two games. And, of course, Western's going to have to stop Debbie Oden and keep her off the boards. And she had 20 boards last night and seven offensive boards. And that's what it's going to wind up to. If Western can keep Oden off the boards, and if Kentucky can stop Chapman, we run in for a big game.
Both teams are talking about zone defenses. The coaches told me before this one got started.
Right. I think we'll see Kentucky open in their familiar 1-3-1 and probably stay with that. If they had trouble with Chapman, they'll go to a box and one on her. And, of course, Western has been very successful all year with their 2-3, and I think you'll see them do that throughout the most of the game.
For our viewers who are not familiar with women's basketball, there are a few rule changes.
Yes. We would have just reminded people that we do have a 30-second shot clock. There is no over and back, and there is no 5-second penetration rule. So the girls have got to shoot that ball within 30 seconds. Fast-moving game, Jenny.
All right, we'll return with player introductions immediately following these messages.
What is it?
National anthem from Memorial Coliseum here in Lexington. The Western Kentucky Hilltoppers against the UK Lady Cats. Western coming in with a 23-7 record. Kentucky 19-9. Now, ladies and gentlemen, the starting lineups for today's championship game. First for the Western Kentucky Lady Toppers. At guard, a 5'7 senior from Olmsted, Kentucky, number 15, Brenda Chapman. At the other guard, a 5'5 senior from Summershade, Kentucky, number 20, Linda Howard. At center, a 5'10 junior from Covington, Kentucky, number 24, Pam Cordenbrock. At forward, a 5'7 junior from Rome, Georgia, number 22, Beth Blanton. And rounding out the Lady Topper lineup, a 5'10 junior, number 25, from Cincinnati, Ohio, Donna Dolman. Western Kentucky is coached by Julia Yater. And now introducing the University of Kentucky Lady Cats. At guard, a 5'5 freshman from East McDowell, Kentucky, number 5, Geri Grigsby. Her running mate in the backcourt is a 5'10 junior from Louisville, number 11, Janet Timperman. At center, a 6-foot senior from Gent, Kentucky, number 20, Pam Browning. At forward, a 6-foot freshman from Louisville, number 21, Maria Donhoff. And at the other forward, a 5'8 sophomore from McRoberts, Kentucky, number 51, Deborah Oden. The Lady Cats are coached by Deborah Yao. Western Kentucky got here by beating Murray 103-88 and Louisville 90-81. The University of Kentucky Lady Cats beat Moorhead 84-76 in last night's semifinals. Sue, this is the third time that the two teams have met this year. University of Kentucky lost at Western 84-82, but the Lady Cats beat the Lady Toppers here in Lexington 73-52.
They did, Denny, by 21 points, and I think you'll see Kentucky open up in the same zone and help them do that. And they cut Brenda Chapman off that night in the box and won.
It'll be Deborah Oden who jumped for Kentucky in the blue uniform. Donna Dolman in red for Western, and the Lady Cats control the sack. This is Geri Grigsby, the little guard, the freshman, who averaged just a shade under 50 points a game in high school last year at McDowell. That's Grigsby with the ball. Western in their familiar 2-3. They're trying to get it inside to Oden. Off her hands and out of bounds. There's the first turnover of the game.
Denny, we're going to try to see Kentucky's going to try to go inside to Oden, who had the great game. And, of course, Kentucky's very strong inside.
Linda Howard bringing it up now for Western. That's Brenda Chapman, 15. Howard is 20. Inside now to Dolman, cutting across the lane. To Corden Brock for the short jumper, and it finally goes down the drain. So Western Kentucky lights up the scoreboard first. It's Pam Cordenbrock, who averages 14 per game. This is Janet Timberman on the attack for Kentucky, right through the hands of Pam Browning, and Kentucky has turned it over twice early. Chapman on the break now for Western, puts it up with the left hand. It won't go. Rebounded by Browning.
Denny, Kentucky's going to have to watch Western because they are extremely quick and will fast break at every chance.
This is Donhoff looking inside for Browning. Now finally gets it to Oden. Missed the short jumper, and the rebound to Donna Dolman, and she gets a bunch of them.
Kentucky's going to have to get on the boards, Denny. Had no one under on the weak side that time.
Linda Howard outside looking for some help. Cross to Brenda Chapman. Here's Chapman, who shoots very well with a hand in her face. They try to force it across the lane. Dolman goes for the loose ball and retrieves it for Western. This is Dolman with the long outside shot off the front of the iron and gets her own rebound. Now Chapman for the short jumper off the back of the iron, and a jump ball call between Timberman and Chapman. It'll be a slight height advantage here to Kentucky.
Denny, Kentucky's going to have to get on the boards. We let Western have three shots there, and Western's very competitive, and they're going to give Kentucky a run for their money tonight.
18:26 to go in the first half. We play 20-minute halves, just as the men do in college basketball. Western on top, 2-0. This is Janet Timberman taking it to the corner. Timberman spinning back and firing it out to Grigsby now on the drive. She likes to penetrate. That's Geri Grigsby with the high pass to Oden. She has it knocked away, and they say Oden touched it last. So Kentucky trying perhaps a bit too hard to force it inside early.
So far, Western's been able to, their defense is cutting off the inside, which is, of course, what Julia Yater hoped that they'd be able to do. And Kentucky's going to have to maybe open up with some outside shooting. They have excellent shooters from the outside.
More than 2 minutes into this thing, and Western pitching a shutout so far. 2-0, Lady Topper. This is Linda Howard, back out to Chapman. Howard, who seldom shoots. Now Dolman from the corner. That high arching jumper of hers misses, and skying for the rebound is Deborah Oden. She can really leap. Maria Donhoff trying to force the pass out ahead, knocked out of bounds by Dolman. It belongs to the Lady Cats beneath their own basket.
Got a sample then, Denny, of how well that 30-inch vertical jump of Deborah Oden skies her up there.
That's Deborah with the basketball into Browning in heavy traffic. Out to Grigsby for the jumper. In and out, no luck for Geri. 17-20 now, and Kentucky yet to score.
Kentucky had no one on the offensive boards again, Denny. They're going to have to get on the offensive boards there.
This is Beth Blanton, who had 33 in their opening tournament win against Murray, and a blocking foul call against Geri Grigsby. That's the first on Geri, the first team foul on the Lady Cats. So Beth Blanton to the line, and she's been busy at that charity stripe in this tournament. So she made 19 of 23 there in the victory over Murray, and there's timeout on the floor right now with a score, Western Kentucky 2, the University of Kentucky Lady Cats nothing. Kentucky Lady Toppers leading Kentucky 2-0, 17:06 to play in the first half. And Beth Blanton, number 22 at the line for Western, a 5'7 junior from Rome, Georgia. This girl has a lot of court savvy, Sue. She does a good job of balancing the court, knows how to make the good pass. She's a floor general for them.
She does, Denny, and she is excellent rolling off the pick at the top of the screen there, on the top of the key, and you'll see her use that quite effectively, I think, against Kentucky, especially if Kentucky goes against in a man-to-man.
Another 75% free throw shooter. Blanton hit them both, and Western up now 4-0. Timperman likes that shot. Won't go this time. Donhoff on the rebound. Back up and in. Maria Donhoff, the first Kentuckian to dent the scorebook.
Denny, is fairly obvious what Coach Yount had him to do. They're going to open up from the outside, I think, with Templeman leading the way.
They've got little Geri Grigsby, the 5'5 freshman, playing the baseline on that 1-3-1 zone, and look at her put it on. She plays it aggressively. Linda Howard, who does not shoot often, as we said, missed that one. Geri Grigsby leading the break for Kentucky. Down to Donhoff. In now to Browning. She's deadly right in there, but attacked from behind by Beth Blanton, and it has it knocked out of bounds. Looks as if Kentucky's going to have to start fanning that ball back to the guards, and they could get some open shooting with the way the Western guards are sagging. See, that's Janet Timperman from long range.
Well, Timperman opened up the shooting, and Denny, you're exactly right, because when the ball goes inside, the guards are sloughing back, and you actually have two men on the forwards, and which leaves an outside guard open.
Beth Blanton with it in trouble. Off to Kordenbrock now from the top of the circle. And although she's a center, she shoots well from there. Deb Roden with another rebound for Kentucky. She had 20 rebounds last night, a season high for the Lady Cats. What an evening's work by Oden last night. 26 points and 20 rebounds. It's loose on the deck now, and a jump ball called between Chapman and Donhoff.
Maria Donhoff's a freshman, of course, from Assumption High School. They were semifinalists last year in the State Girls High School Championship. And what an addition to this Kentucky team. A very rugged, rugged forward for Kentucky.
A slight height advantage to the Lady Cats here. The UK controlled it, but somebody was in the circle, I think, and so it will go over on the violation to Western Kentucky.
That's right, Denny. See what Western does this time, and Kentucky has tightened up their 1-3-1 and moved to a trap defense here, and we'll see if they can work a little bit to steal the ball.
Janet Timperman using the quick hands there, reaching in against Blanton, who gets it off to Kordenbrock. That's Blanton shooting on the move and missed it. The rebound taken down by Pam Browning.
I know Debbie L. wanted to run in the beginning, Denny, and she hadn't much opportunity yet, but I'm sure Kentucky will get going here in a little bit.
Now the Lady Cats can take the lead on this trip. Donhoff from the corner. Oden going up for the rebound. Now she's on the deck with it, and a jump ball call. Won't see many better performances than the one that Debbie Oden put on here last night, Sue.
That's true, Denny. She's from Jenkins High School in Tiny McRoberts, Kentucky, and led Jenkins to the semifinals in the girls' state 2 years ago. Quite a competitor.
To show you just how well she can jump, Deborah had 16 rebounds on three different occasions in the regular season this year. And again, somebody was in the circle for Kentucky, so they've lost two jump balls in a row.
Yes, Denny, I think what it is the jumper is jumping over the half-court line, the mark line there, and, of course, that is a violation. You rarely see that called in men's, but they do call it in the women's.
The officials are Sue Pine and Glenn Wells. That's Donna Dolman in heavy traffic. Can't get it to go. Another rebound by Deborah Oden, and a foul called on Debbie. Coach Deborah Yao, the Lady Cats, is out complaining. She didn't think so at all. That foul on Deborah Oden is her first and the team's second.
The Western set up for that when they knew she was in position, and they're going to run behind her to try to draw the foul.
Linda Howard with it, trying to force it into the lane, and tied up by Pam Browning. So another jump ball.
Many things are getting a little hot out there, and of course these two teams are intense when they play each other. Great state rivals.
Janet Timperman trying to chase it down. It goes out, and let's see who it'll belong to, or will they jump it again? No, they'll give it to Western. At side court, Brenda Chapman to toss it in. Quite a contrast from last night's Lady Cat game, which they scored 84 points in. Chapman forcing up the jumper and missing it. Oden chasing down the rebound for Kentucky. 14:30 to go, first half, tied at 4 apiece. Janet Timperman with her long lob. Swish.
Denny, she hit about 6 of those last night, and that's an excellent shot for her, out about 20 feet. Excellent long shooter.
Janet is a streak shooter, and when she's hot, she can really fill it up. Only 35%, though, on the season. And finally getting that one to fall was Donna Dolman. First two of the night for Dolman, who averages a dozen points a game. Browning working the high post now for Kentucky. inside for Oden. Look at her go up, but missed the shot. The rebound by Kortenbrock.
Under the goal a little bit too far, Jenny, and she and Pam Browning worked that play particularly well.
Kentucky staying with the 1-3-1. Beth Blanton put on the good quick move, shoots on the move and missed it, and a rebound foul called against Corky Kortenbrock. That's her first and the team's first on Western.
And if you remember, Kortenbrock made the difference in the semifinals last year against Kentucky. She came off the bench with four fouls and scored six straight points and spelled a doom for Kentucky.
This is Maria Donhoff, the freshman for Kentucky, looking inside, now gives it to Timperman. She missed the jumper, but it's Donhoff on the rebound. Knocked out of her hands from behind, and another jump ball.
It's a good example there, Denny. Western is sending the guards sliding back. They're sagging in on the forwards, and you have two people actually going at the ball every time a forward has it for Kentucky.
Pam Browning with a big height advantage off to Timperman. Donhoff into Browning. A good pass, but Pam missed the shot and the rebound taken down by Donna Dolman, who gets 8.5 rebounds a game. Well, Kentucky so far has done a super job of shutting off Chapman, but that's Linda Howard who hits from the other wing.
I was just thinking that, Denny, and Chapman hasn't had a field goal, I don't believe, and the 1-3-1's working very effectively against her.
Pam Browning now working the post for Kentucky has got Timperman open on the side. She'll launch the shot. Two more. Janet Timperman with 6 points early for Kentucky. She averages 7.5.
Denny, you mentioned she's a streak shooter, and she's on a streak of three right now.
Her season high was 24 against Marshall, by the way. Linda Howard operating outside off to Chapman. That's her favorite shot. Won't go this time. Dolman on the rebound. Back to Chapman. Brenda Chapman on the drive. A good block by Donhoff. Chapman got it back and is fouled. Maria Donhoff committing the foul. It's her first, and they third on Kentucky. So two shots coming now to Brenda Chapman, who, as Sue Feimster told you in our pregame comments, has scored 61 points in Western's two tournament games thus far. 34 against Murray, 27 against Louisville. Timeout on the floor right now with a score. Chapman will be at the line for Western Kentucky as we resume here. Brenda is about as good a free throw shooter as you'll ever see, 84% from the line. Her season average point-wise, 20 per game. A good look there at Brenda Chapman, one of the better women players in the state of Kentucky, that's for sure.
Excellent form, Denny, and you'll notice that she stays at the free throw line, which is one of the techniques now that they're teaching free throw shooters not to move off the line, keep your position.
Unless you miss it. If you miss that first one, then get
that's
off
right.
the line.
She missed that one. One of the few we'll see her miss.
12 minutes to go now in the first half. Western by 1, 9-8. This is Maria Donhoff for the short jumper. Missed it long, and the rebound taken down by Donna Dolman. Dolman gets excellent position for Western. She's always in good rebounding position. Beth Blanton had her pass blocked by Debbie Oden. Oden had 5 steals last night. This is Geri Grigsby now leading the break for Kentucky to Timperman. Inside for Donhoff. The fadeaway by Maria is perfect.
Excellent, Denny. Excellent ball work there and ball handling by both teams.
Donhoff had 15 against Moorhead last night. She's got 4 already in this one. 10-9. Now the Lady Cats out in front. This is Beth Blanton will take the jump shot and hit it.
Beth Blanton's a tremendous competitor. Of course, Beth had 8 points last night, but 33 big points against Murray in their opening round.
Pam Browning with the high lob for Donhoff, a dangerous pass, and now a foul called. And it's a charge against Maria Donhoff. 2 fouls on Donhoff, 4 on Kentucky as a team. Substitutions now for the Lady Cats. Debbie Mack, little number 15, coming into the lineup. A 5'3 junior from Lexington. She replaces Geri Grigsby. And Linda Edelman, number 10, a 5'9 sophomore from Havertown, Pennsylvania, is in replacing Maria Donhoff. So it's Edelman now playing the point guard position in the 1-3-1, and Debbie Mack playing the baseline. That's Pam Kortenbrock shooting up over Mack, and that could be a problem. They might exploit that, Sue.
Yes, Denny, I think you're going to see that mismatch used. And, of course, Western's one of the best passing teams you'll ever see. They're extremely good passers. Kentucky's, again, going to have to get on the offensive boards.
Debbie Oden with the turnaround jumper, it won't fall, but a foul called on Donna Dolman. Another substitution for Kentucky, big number 43, is Janine Mozeth. And Janet Timperman comes out. Mozeth, who just checked in, is a 6'2 freshman from Zweibrücken, Germany.
Denny, last night, Janine, she's just been coming on. She's been used as a substitute in 6 minutes. Had 3 steals, 3 assists, 1 field goal, and 3 block shots.
And that's nothing compared to what she did at Tennessee last week, hitting 10 out of 13,
that's
a
right.
Super performance in relief against the Lady Vols. Well, Debbie Oden missed them both, but now gets a third chance, and it still won't go. Hortenbrock in trouble. Brings it back outside to Linda Howard. Good block by Mozeth. And a traveling call.
Jenny, she can intimidate you. She's 6'2", and she appears much bigger on the court.
Janine Mozeth's father, who was in the service, and that's the reason why Janine has traveled all over the world, is 6'7", and her mother is 6 foot. She's got a brother that's 6'7".
Yeah.
This is Pam Browning inside, Kentucky All-America candidate coming in this season, fouled from behind by Pam Cordenbrock.
See, Denny, one of the things that's happened now with Janine in the lineup is Browning's moved out to forward, which, of course, gives Kentucky a slight advantage over the 5'10 Cordenbrock, Browning at 6 feet.
This is little Debbie Mack, has the pass slapped back at her. Linda Howard retrieves the ball, a little contact but no whistle, and now Chapman with a left-handed layup. Brenda Chapman scoring her first basket of the game.
Today they're letting the girls play tonight, and a lot of contact out there.
There's a little that they didn't get away with. Linda Howard called for reaching in against Janine Mozeth, and on Howard, it's the first personal foul and the third on Western as a team. 9:51 to play in the first half. Western Kentucky leading the UK Lady Cats 15-10.
Denny, Western's a very intensive, competitive team. I don't think you'll see any team anywhere in the country more intense than they are.
That's Janine Mozeth missing the jumper, and Pam Browning called for a foul, trying to get rebounding position underneath offensively for Kentucky. That foul on Pam Browning is her first, and the team's fifth.
Denny, Kentucky's still only getting one shot at the boards, and they're going to have to do better than that tonight.
And we get a double dribble call there against Linda Howard. It appeared that Linda Edelman reached in and got a hand on the ball, but the official didn't see it that way. A double dribble called against Linda Howard of Western. So on the violation, the Lady Cats go on the attack. Linda Edelman with it out front. Western switching defense. Janine Mozeth trying to get it off to Oden, who made a good save. Now back to Edelman. And she's called for traveling.
Denny, what we're seeing now is we've got Beth Lane down there, and she's guarding anyone that comes in the lane, man-to-man. It's a box and one now that Western's employing.
That's Brenda Chapman around and out. Janine Mozeth on the rebound. She battles Chapman with it. And it'll be a jump ball, a big height advantage here to Kentucky's Janine Mozeth. Pam Browning coming out of the Kentucky lineup, and Maria Donhoff back in.
Of course, Denny, the big thing today is that if Kentucky gets in foul trouble, the people that get in the bonus, free throws are going to play an important part.
Janine Mozeth gets the tip ahead to Edelman, a two-on-two break. Edelman stops and launches the shot, in and out. Brenda Chapman bringing it back the other way in a hurry for Western. That's Beth Blanton on the drive. The ice cream scoop won't go, and Mozeth with the rebound. Outlet pass to Edelman, who runs into Linda Howard, and a foul called on Howard. That's the second on Linda. And you talk about a competitor. Miss Howard is really a fiery young lady.
She certainly is, Denny. And, of course, one of the things Coach Yao said she was going to try to do is clear off the boards with the first outlet pass and just fire the ball down the floor and let Edelman go for it.
New girl in the lineup for Western Kentucky, number 11, Karen Frierson. She's just a freshman and extremely quick. Watch her. Inside the pass intended for Mozeth, and a jump ball call. Donna Dolman did a good job of cutting off the passing lane, and a jump ball now between Dolman and Mozeth.
Western's really working on defense tonight, Denny. It's keeping them in the game and keeping the ball away from Kentucky on the boards.
Janine Mozeth controls the tap out to Debbie Mack of the Lady Cats. Long jumper by Edelman. Swish. Linda Edelman with that great form, the same kind of form used by her brother Ray when he played for the
Kentucky Wildcats not so long ago.
Then Kentucky's changed defenses now. They're in a 2-1-2. This gives them a little more board strength, Coach Al feels.
That's Linda Howard from straight away trying to answer for Western. Can't do it. And the foul on Debbie Oden for going over the back. That's the second on Oden and 16 fouls on Kentucky. So Western will be shooting now when Kentucky commits the next personal foul.
Denny, Coach Yeager told me in the beginning that one of the things she's going to try to do is keep Oden off the boards. And so far, she's done a fairly good job.
This is Karen Frierson off to Dolman. 8 minutes exactly to go now as Dolman shoots and misses from the outside, but Howard gets it back for Western. 15-12, the Lady Toppers leading. Oden gone for the steal. Touch last by Western. Good hustle by Debbie Oden.
Extremely quick, Denny. Deceptive speed.
Lady Cats can cut the Western advantage to one on this trip. Straight away, Debbie Mack.
Debbie Mack's been sick all week in the bed with the flu, Denny, and she's a bomber right here from Lexington Lafayette. Hit one about 22 feet out.
16 points in her last game against Western. And they got a violation.
This particular lineup, and especially the change that Coach Dowd made, the 2-1-2 defense, has seemed to have some effect against Western and not quite handling it.
Mack is open. Rebounded by Donhoff and a foul call. It's on Beth Blanton of Western Kentucky. That's the first on Beth and the fifth team foul on the Lady Toppers. So on the common foul now, it'll be the Lady Cats ball along the baseline beneath their own hoop. 15-14, Western on top, 7:19 to go first half. This is the finals of the Kentucky Women's Intercollegiate Basketball Tournament.
Kentucky needs badly to score on this trip down the floor.
Inbounds pass to Debbie Mack, out to Edelman. Now to Mozeth in the middle for the turnaround jumper. She's got it.
Denny, she's coming along, and Coach Allen had to move her shot from chest high up to over her head, and that's a good example of how well Janine has responded to her tutelage.
Blanton on the wing will try to answer for Western. Won't go. Dolman on the rebound. Back out straight away to Linda Howard. She'll launch the long one. Rebounded by Mozeth. They told you she's a world traveler. She started playing basketball at the age of 10 in Japan. That's Maria Donhoff missing the shot. Mozeth going for the rebound. And a foul called on Janine. Can you imagine what she must have been like beside some of those Japanese women, Sue?
I'll tell you. Denny, she's a volleyball player, too, and we have a
bonus is in effect here, by the
situation,
way.
Yes.
Janine's a very free spirit, isn't she? Kind of a female Bill Walton, you might say.
She is, Denny, and she's really a delight. She's a very unusual lady. She likes classical music and kind of adores the top 40.
Pam Kordenbrock with another shot coming now. Pam looking for her sixth point. Made 8 of 13 tries from the field against Louisville last night. Scored 20 points, and there's 6 for Kordenbrock in this one.
Denny, Miss Kordenbrock will be getting married this summer. And Western has one girl that is married on their team.
Donhoff looking inside now, out to Mack. Edelman on the other wing. Donhoff moving through the lane, finds herself in trouble and loses the ball. Karen Frierson on the steal for Western. Lady Toppers still owning a one-point lead, 17-16, 6 minutes and 20 seconds to go in the first half. Beth Blanton had some shooting room, didn't want it. Now Blanton will launch the jumper, swish. Beth Blanton with 6 points, that's half of her season average. And Kentucky wants the timeout. Timeout on the floor with a score. Western Kentucky 19, the UK Lady Cats 16. Back at Memorial Coliseum, Denny Treese with you along with Sue Feimster for the finals of the Women's State Basketball College Championships. That's Debbie Oden. Got it.
Denny, you rarely see her shoot from the forward shot, and this is one of the things she's been working on. She's a tremendous forward. She's a center in high school.
Brenda Chapman back in now for Western. Underneath it goes to Dolman. She tries to bank it in and does. Donna Dolman with the basket. She's got 4 points in the game. Maria Donhoff waiting for little Debbie Mack to come down and set up the offense. Now Donhoff will launch the jumper. The rebound by Dolman.
Denny, Kentucky didn't have anyone on the weak side again. No one there on the boards.
21-18, Western leading. 5:18 to go, first half. And the Chapman. Well, the UK bench is up calling for a walking violation against Chapman, but they end up getting a foul against Linda Edelman. That's the first on Linda, and Western is in the bonus, so Kordenbrock will go back to the line. You see Janet Timperman, number 11, coming in for Kentucky, and Debbie Mack going out.
Yes, Denny, I think we're going to have to see this because Kentucky, after that timeout, went back to the 1-3-1. They had Mack back on the baseline, who's only 5'2". And Western's used it once for a score underneath with Dolman.
Pam Kordenbrock, the Covington, Kentucky product, has hit three in a row from the line. Can't make it four, and Mozeff comes down with the rebound with authority. Timperman on the dribble, off to Mozeff. Shook herself free, and finally down the drain. Janine Mozeff has 4 points in the game. She had a 2.9 grade point average in pre-law last semester. Nothing wrong with that. Frierson loses it and retrieves. Now Brenda Chapman on the wing. The Kentucky defense really doing the job on Western's high-scoring Brenda Chapman. Whistle and reaching in call against Linda Edelman, who has a smile on her face, and I don't think she thought she was guilty, Sue.
Well, Denny, I think it was kind of what you call a tacky or a cheap foul there, something just kind of contact incidental that happened. One of the things that would be interesting to see if this particular tall lineup with the 5'10 guards that you have in Edelman and Timperman can affect the Western's guards. Timperman played, of course, with the team in Europe all summer at the guard position, anticipating she would be a guard this year.
That's the Athletes in Action team that was coached by Debbie Yao. Debbie Oden fires the pass off to Edelman. Edelman's off badly. You could see it when she launched it, and it was not going to be there. And a jump ball called now as Oden and Mozeff just sandwiched Donna Dolman.
Denny, Janine Mozeff must have arms that belong to a seven-foot person. She's about the only person I know that could do that. Of course, they gave the jump ball to Debbie.
She files her fingernails on the sidewalk, as they say. 24-20, Western leading, 4:15 to go, and Mozeff tied up and called for traveling. Karen Frierson from straight away. No luck for Karen. It went down and wouldn't stay. On the outlet pass, Janet Timperman not looking, and so the Kentucky turnover gives it right back to Western. This is Karen Frierson calling out the play.
Denny, Kentucky has begun to switch defenses. They're now in their box and one with Timperman. They're taking Chapman man-to-man.
Kordenbrock's jumper won't go. Linda Edelman on the rebound. So we'll watch for the Kentucky defense the next time down, a box and chaser. Janet Timperman had a notion, didn't take it. Gives to Edelman. One dribble to get a little closer and then missed the jump shot.
Didn't I believe Frierson got her hand on that ball a little bit, just enough to make it go astray.
Edelman normally shoots with much better form, and she's launched the last couple. It appears that she's been forcing it just a bit. She, too, has been ill, though, and has been a little pale. Look at Beth Blanton operate inside. For a little girl, she was in amongst the tall timbers doing some damage and was fouled.
Denny Western's given us an example of how a short team can go against a tall one if you just think that you can. And right now, I think they're just gutting it out with Kentucky because they think they can win this game. Tremendous competitors.
I believe the foul was on Donhoff, was it not, or was it on Mozeff?
No, I believe it was on Mozeff.
Okay. That's the second on Janine. Beth Blanton can't hit the second free throw. She's got 7 points in the game. This is Janet Timperman on the drive. Good pass off to Oden, but she just wasn't ready. substitutions now. We've got Beth Blanton going to the bench for Western Kentucky. And into the game is Sue Rubin, a 5'8 sophomore from LaGrange, Illinois. Number 21, Rubin. This is Cordenbrock at the post. Goes right around Browning, but missed the shot. Oden comes out of the woods with it, yeah, holding her eye.
I think she got a finger in the eye there.
Play the steal by the quick Karen Frierson. An easy two for the Western.
Kentucky's gone to sleep, Denny.
27-20. Western's advantage is 7 points as Debbie Yao gets Geri Grigsby up off the bench. She'll be in at the first opportunity to guard for the Lady Cat. This is Linda Edelman looking for some help. Frierson with another steal, but Donoff gets it back. Now Timperman with a shot. Write him down.
Denny, she's keeping Kentucky in the ball game. I believe that's her 8 points.
It is, and Janet averages just 7.5 on the season from Louisville Assumption. Timperman, by the way, was second to Browning in scoring and rebounding on the Lady Cats the last 2 years. Dolman missing the outside shot, and Oden with another rebound. This is Donhoff back to Timperman. Now Donhoff open on the side. Around and out, and a jump ball call on the rebound. Cordenbrock and Browning will jump it. And here's Geri Grigsby checking in, and Linda Edelman coming out of the lineup for the Lady Cats.
I think Denny, Coach Mel, wanted to get a little more ball control in here. Of course, Edelman has been sick all week with the flu. Not quite herself.
Donhoff hiked it right between her legs, and we got another violation. Apparently, Kentucky jumped across that line again.
I believe so, Denny. Of course, you can't come down across that line. You've got to stay on your half.
1:33 to go in the first half. Western leading 27-22. The finals of the Kentucky Women's Intercollegiate Tournament. That's Karen Frierson missing the jumper. Look at Oden go up to the rebound and fouled by Sue Rubin.
Denny Dolman held her hand up, and if that was her foul, I thought it was on Rubin.
I thought the official said 2-1, which would be Rubin. But you're right, Dolman did hold her hand up.
I'm not sure.
Well, I'll put it in the book for Rubin, and we'll put Oden at the line and check it later. Debbie Oden now with 3 points. She'd missed her first two tries from the free throw line, averaging 11 points per game. But more importantly, averaging 10 rebounds a ball game.
I think right now Kentucky just needs to relax a little bit, start running their plays. And of course, Western's, it's all been Western so far in this half.
This is Corky Cordenbrock into Donna Dolman for the short jumper. Missed it. Timperman on the rebound, fouled by Brenda Chapman. That's the first on Brenda. And Kentucky in the bonus. So they'll walk the other way with Timperman to shoot. Janet wants to be a legal secretary.
Denny, she's one of six people, one of six kids in her family. They all play basketball, and she has two younger sisters, one playing at Sacred Heart, and a little one, who's 10 years old, Susan, is playing for a grade school.
Janet can become the first player in the game to hit double digits if she connects on this free one. Won't go down, and the rebound by Donna Dolman. 27-25, the Lady Cats within a basket now with 56 seconds to go in the half. Karen Frierson off to Cordenbrock. Now Dolman gone through the lane, laying it up and in. Good play by the Lady Toppers. Dolman on the scoring end. 6 points for Donna. Is Geri Grigsby bringing it up now for the Lady Cats. Timperman with the long shot. Going up for the rebound is Pam Browning. No basket, but a foul called on Sue Rubin.
Pam Browning looked like her old self there, didn't she? She went way up in a lot of traffic to get that ball. Pam's the only senior on this team.
Well, they just held up one foul on Rubin, and so the other one had to be on Donna Dolman. So we got one on Dolman now and one on Sue Rubin. Pam Browning at the line for Kentucky.
Kentucky needs to make these, Denny, to go in and close this gap before they go into the locker room at halftime.
Pam Browning, who averaged 25.5 points per game last year, has seen her average dip to 12 this season, and these are her first 2 points of the first half. Browning will have to score if Kentucky's to win this game.
Exactly right, Denny. Western will probably go for one shot if they can beat the shot clock here.
Sue Rubin to Cordenbrock, out front to Frierson. Dolman will launch the shot from the side. Rebound taken down by Browning, and we got a foul called on Pam Cordenbrock. She has a look of disbelief on her face, but the foul on Turkey is her third. That could be a big factor.
Big factor, Denny. And, of course, Browning had position there, and none of these girls want to go out and sit on the bench. And I know Cordenbrock got in foul trouble last year when they were playing Kentucky and waited and waited and came in with about 4 minutes to go and saved the game for Western. Browning back at the line, and Kentucky needs these two.
Pam's got a pretty good streak going from the free throw line. She didn't shoot well from the field last night, Sue. Only 3 of 11, but was 9 of 11 from the charity stripe against Moorhead.
She's an excellent free throw shooter, shooting about 72%, I believe, for the season.
Got them both.
Tie ball game, Denny, in 20 seconds, and Shirley Weston will go for one shot here.
Bad pass. Buzzer. Geri Grigsby to Timperman. 6 seconds away from intermission. Timperman with a long one. Debbie Oden will get one last shot, and it won't go. So that's the end of the first half, and we're all tied up. Western Kentucky last night, and I thought Western's defense was vulnerable. It appeared to me that they did not do a very good job of fronting inside, and Audrey Baines really killed them. A big girl from Louisville last night scored a lot of points. It looked like she could have got even more if they'd have exploited it more, but Kentucky not getting the ball inside, not getting much scoring from their people down low.
Right, Denny. I think one of the things is Julia's made the coach for Western has made an adjustment from last night. I think they were overplaying at the forwards a little bit last night and allowing that pass to get into Louisville, which is also extremely tall. And they've adapted that, and they're also sending the guard back anytime the ball does get in the middle. So the forward that has the ball has got to contend with the person guarding her and the person in the guard trying to take the ball away from her on the front. And Kentucky's either going to have to kick the ball out and hit the open shot out about 15 feet, which is one of the things they're going to have to do. The other thing they're going to have to do is they're going to have to continue their outside shooting. And Timperman, which is on a streak right now, I believe she has eight points, 4 field goals. And once you open up your outside shooting, you have good balance and can go inside back and forth. And, of course, Western's tenacious defense has kept them in this ball game, and they are tremendous competitors, and Kentucky's going to have their hands full if they want to win this game tonight.
It's funny what a difference one night can make, because when the Lady Cats beat Moorhead, the defending state champions, last night, 84-76, second shots really won the game for Kentucky, and today they're getting no second shots.
Right, Denny. They're just not on the offensive boards as well as they could be. Of course, when they go in their 2-1-2 zone, they're beginning to get on the boards, and of course they're beginning to draw fouls, and I think we're seeing that. And Western is generally a first half team, and I imagine Kentucky's going to come out here and try to blow Western out right here in the middle in the first opening minutes, and I think that's what we need to look for.
Here's some news for you University of Kentucky basketball fans. Joe Hall and his Cats will play Florida State in the Mideast Regionals this Saturday. Florida State paired against them. Will return out of Memorial Coliseum in Lexington after these messages. From the Commissioner's Office of the Kentucky High School Athletic Association has joined us here at halftime. And Bill, it's going to be our great pleasure to televise the finals this year of the state tournament from Louisville, and it should be another great one.
Denny, we're certainly looking forward to it, and we're very thankful for WKYT televising it, because they have the last 2 years, I know, and we're looking forward to another great tournament this year. We feel like we have a great field lined up for the boys' tournament, of course, and we're looking forward to our girls' tournament. And we having what do you call tournament mania? Is that a good word?
That's a good word. You had a lot of scowls on the faces of some of the coaches around when the drawing was made. Well, for both tournaments, both boys and girls, because just the luck of the draw has a lot of top-ranked teams with the possibility of meeting early. Apollo and Shelby County could meet right off the bat.
They could meet the first game on Thursday afternoon. And, of course, presently they are ranked number 1 and number 2 in our polls by the Courier Journal and the AP, of course. The girls, of course, we'll go back to the girls, and we have our girls' tournament. We have, I think, 4 of the top-rated teams and girls all in the lower bracket. So I'm sure that the coaches were a little upset at the draw, yes.
Has there been any thought given to seeding the teams going into the state tournament?
This has been discussed, Denny, but really, in tournament, they hate to seed, for such as the state tournament, because youngsters that do have a mediocre season, they certainly can make a lot of amends by going to the state tournament and, you know, playing and representing their school well. So I doubt if a seed is any way close.
Can you see any advantage to doing anything different other than just the luck of the draw, Bill? Any other alternatives whatsoever?
Denny, the only thing I can see maybe is trying to eliminate the two games on the street is a difficult task. It's been done and will be done this year. Our board has discussed it, and I really don't know, but I feel like if anything is done different, that we maybe could eliminate the two games on Saturday some way.
I just am curious, has there ever been any talk about dividing the basketball teams into classes now and dividing up the tournament at all, like some other states do? Ohio, for instance, does that. Indiana, of course, does, just like Kentucky, and throws them all in together.
Denny, yes, this is discussed possibly, I'd say, every year at our board, and presently we still are in the one class in basketball, and how long we will remain there.
At Memorial Coliseum, Denny Treese with you along with Sue Feimster, and as we look at the shooting percentages for the first half, neither team burning it up. Kentucky hit 35% and Western only 29%, and a couple of the girls that we thought would shoot extremely well today, like Brenda Chapman of Western, for instance, who came in here averaging 20 points per game, hit only one of six tries during the first half, and Maria Donhoff, the fine freshman for Kentucky, was only two of seven, so perhaps tournament jitters, Sue.
I think so, Denny. I think both of these teams, it means so much to them to go on next week into the Region 2 Championship. They're both very emotional, and of course, this is a very intense game for both of them. They're intense in-state rivals.
There are the scoring totals for the first half for the Western Kentucky Lady Toppers, led by Pam Cordenbrock, their fine center, with 9 points. Beth Blanton has seven. Brenda Chapman held to only three. She averages 20 a game again. Donna Dolman only 6 points, and she shot only 3 of 10. Normally much better than that. Karen Frierson came in to get two, and Linda Howard, who started at a guard, had 2 points for the Lady Toppers. Looking down over the rebound totals now, we have Kentucky getting 27 rebounds to 17 for Western. And again, that seems inconceivable to me. It seemed as if Western was getting a lot of more defensive rebounds than Kentucky was. Now, the Kentucky scoring, Janet Timperman leading the way with 9 points, and a bunch of people with four, Browning, Donhoff, Odin, Moseth, and Linda Edelman, who came in to get two. Does that rebounding total surprise you, Sue?
Surprisingly, I think, of course, they're probably defensive boards for Western mostly, and of course, Kentucky are mostly defensive. They certainly weren't offensive. They were not getting the second shot. I think one of the things Kentucky's going to have to do is, one, get on the offensive boards, and two, get some scoring out of her and get some offensive boards. And, of course, the big stuff that Beth Blanton and Pam Cordenbrock both have nine points apiece. And Cordenbrock has three fouls, and I'm sure Coach Yow's going to try to pull that fourth foul off on her.
One thing that I'm sure Coach Deborah Yow of Kentucky talked about at halftime was the 12 turnovers committed by her team in the first half. We'll have a second half tip-off in just a moment, but first, this message.
When it's your turn to make the sandwiches, insist on making the best.
Women's Intercollegiate Tournament, 29-29. Western Kentucky against UK, and I think a significant fact, Sue Feimster, is that Western has been a good first-half team and not a very good second-half team all year. When these two teams met at Western, the Lady Toppers scored over 50 points in the first half, led by over 20, and wound up winning the game by what, 2 points?
2 points, Denny, and I think we're going to see Kentucky really press Western right here, right from the beginning.
And Kentucky wins the tap. Janet Timperman to Geri Grigsby. Browning at the high post, cross court to Timperman. Inside to Donhoff, who had a poor shooting half in the first 20 minutes and can't get it to fall here, and a jump ball call on the rebound.
Well, Kentucky has at least been able to go right inside from the beginning, Denny, and of course they had two people there with the ball.
Pam Browning controls the tap out to Geri Grigsby. Browning trying to dribble herself free, fans it out to Grigsby. High lob intended for Odin underneath and stolen by Cordenbrock of Western. 30 seconds into the second half, tied 29-all. Linda Howard calling out the play.
Denny, Kentucky's open again in a box and one.
That's Pam Cordenbrock, and no luck for her. Went in and out, and a foul called on the rebound. This is on Beth Blanton.
Denny, it looks like Kentucky's made some adjustments during halftime. They are going to the boards extremely well these first two trips down the floor.
Deborah Yow giving some instructions there to little guard Geri Grigsby. Dangerous pass.
Timperman got it back. It's inside to Browning now to Timperman. Won't go. Rebounded by Donna Dolman. She had 11 rebounds in the first half of this one. Pam Browning has lost her shoe. It's right out in front of us at the western end of the court. So Browning playing a defense without it now, and we'll have an official's timeout for Browning to put the shoe on.
Kenny, while we're resting, Western looks rather tired right now, and Kentucky started out running, and this might be a crucial factor. Western has had two very, very tough games, and of course Kentucky playing only their first game last night, and the fatigue factor might become a very crucial factor in this ball game.
This is Browning. She has it where she wants it. Off to Timperman. Inside for Donhoff. The turnaround by Maria won't go. And the rebound by Beth Blanton. She'll lead the break herself. Doesn't like the odds. Stops and gives it off to Linda Howard. Now Kordenbrock with a turnaround jumper. Pam Kordenbrock with 11 points. Leads all scorers in the game. Averages 14 per game. 53% field goal shooter on the year, Pam Kordenbrock. This is Pam Browning trying to answer for Kentucky. Will it fall? Yes, attempt at a three-pointer for Pam Browning. No, it does not count. A foul called on Linda Howard.
I believe that was a reaching in foul, Denny. I think it was not on before the shot, before she started up.
Debbie Yao is beside herself. She is extremely upset at that call. She thought Browning was definitely in the act of shooting. That's Timperman with the outside shot. Ball loose underneath and a jump call. That foul, by the way, on Linda Howard was her third.
Kenny, we hope that that particular call won't upset Kentucky's pace. Of course, something like that, you never know.
And it would have been Pam Browning's first basket of the game. It might have been the spark that she needs. Now that one goes out of bounds. Another Lady Cat turnover. As we told you, they made 12 of them in the first 20 minutes.
See Grigsby matching up with Chapman all the way down there.
And Kordenbrock in the center of the lane missed the shot. Debbie Oden on the rebound. She also had 11 rebounds in the first half. Quite an individual battle between Dolman and Oden. This is Debbie Oden. Rebounded by Donhoff. Back up. Band in. Maria Donhoff.
She muscled her way in there, Denny, and that's what Kentucky's been famous for all year, is their muscle, and it's the first time we've seen it tonight.
Maria's got a brother who was a small college All-American at Ohio Northern, and another brother playing now at Bellarmine in Louisville. That's Linda Howard with a long shot, rebounded by Oden.
Kentucky.
3 minutes into the second half. We're tied 31-31. Geri Grigsby ahead to Maria Donhoff. Tried to force the pass inside for Browning, retrieved by Grigsby. Now Timperman is open. Rebounded by Browning. Back up. And it goes.
Not much Pam Kordenbrock could do on that. She's playing with three fouls, Denny, and the fourth one will certainly spell doom for the inside game for Western.
Lady Cats by two now. 33-31. Kentucky staying with that box and chaser. That's Beth Blanton missing the shot, and Oden with another rebound. She just keeps rolling them up, Sue.
Denny, of course, one of the good things about a box and chaser, it gives the defensive team a good in-possession position. Of course, it leaves their middle open.
That's Pam Browning. And Debbie Oden, or rather Debbie Yao, the Kentucky coach, again calling for a foul, but no whistle. She thought Browning was hacked on the wrist as she took it up. 16 minutes to play in the game as Linda Howard launches one from downtown and misses. Oden going for the rebound, knocked it out, and the ball belongs to Western. Here's Linda Edelman checking in for Kentucky. And Browning will come out. So Kentucky now with a very small lineup, Sue.
Yes, it looks like they're going to try to go with a small, quick lineup. Browning probably needs a rest. She's been right in the thick of things since this half started.
That's Linda, or rather Donna Dolman, shooting that rafter tickler and missed everything in a jump ball call on the rebound between Timperman and Beth Blanton. Linda Edelman, who just checked in, is a 5'9 sophomore, and so they lose a few inches of height in the exchange there. Get your Timperman gets the tap off to Linda Edelman. This is Geri Grigsby spinning her way to the hoop. The scoop is good.
An excellent one-on-one player, Denny. She may be small, but she can take just about anybody on one-on-one with the moves that she has.
And in a three-year career at McDowell, she averaged 46 points. That's incredible. Shot blocked by Odin and retrieved by Maria Donhoff. Off to Edelman. Kentucky with a four-point advantage. Edelman into Odin with the turnaround jumper. It won't go. Donhoff on the rebound, back up and in. Kentucky with their biggest lead of the game. Maria Donhoff with that basket has 8 points now, and it's 37-31 with 15 minutes to play.
Timeout.
Western's going to have to talk things over and regroup. Timeout on the floor with a score. The Kentucky Lady Cats 37, the Western Kentucky Lady Toppers 31. 14:50 to go in the game, and Kentucky leading by six. A bad pass, Karen Frierson threw it away, and so it goes back over to the Lady Cats.
Okay, that 1-3-1 zone is bothering Western again, and this is the early thing that Coach Yao hoped to do, is come out steaming, open first half, and try to put Western away.
Debbie Odin in heavy traffic put on a good move but missed the shot. Linda Edelman retrieves it for Kentucky in circle. They'll set the offense again. Geri Grigsby with another drive. Off the glass, it won't go. Rebounded by Pam Kortenbrock. Outlet pass to Frierson. She doesn't like the odds. Kentucky got back quickly on defense. Good transition there. Kortenbrock has it go through her hands. Odin retrieves for Kentucky and flips it off to Linda Edelman. Now Frierson going for the steal, knocks it out of bounds. Touch last for the Western girl, and so it belongs to Kentucky. We were tied 29-29 at halftime, and Western has put only 2 points on the board in the second half, in the first 6 minutes of the second half. High lob pass for Donhoff underneath, and she ran in to Donna Dolman. The foul on Maria Donhoff.
I believe that's
his third,
Denny. Of course, we now have two people in, not real foul trouble, but two people in. They have to be a little more cautious. Kortenbrock with three and Donhoff with three.
Brenda Chapman, the 20-point-per-game scorer for Western, on the bench. Kentucky was doing such a good job in that box and chaser that Julia Yater, the Western coach, decided she had to take her out. That's Donna Dolman breaking through the lane, getting a good pass and laying it in for Western. Donna Dolman now with 8 points.
There was a breakdown in Kentucky's defense. One of the guards did not slide down to cover that lane.
Here's Geri Grigsby with the open shot. Rebounded by Dolman. Western trying to get it down in a hurry now. Ahead four, Kortenbrock, and tapped out of bounds. They say Corky Kortenbrock touched it. Last, it belongs to Kentucky. Substitution now for the Lady Cats. Pam Browning is in, and Maria Dunoff has gone out.
Great defensive effort there by Odin, who streaked down court to block that ball.
37-33. The UK Lady Cats on top now. Linda Edelman launching the long one. Debbie Odin on the rebound. Linda Edelman has been short with all of her shots tonight, Sue, and I think that flu bug has definitely weakened her.
I think so, Denny. I also think she's a little bit out of her range. She was out well beyond 20 feet there, about 21, 22 feet.
Foul there on Beth Blanton. That's the third on Beth. Linda Edelman's parents, by the way, are in town to see this game from Pennsylvania. Her father, a former basketball coach, and a very good one. Very respected basketball mind.
Yes, Denny, and she has a brother that's one of the top 50 high school basketball players in the country right now.
Pam Browning at the line, and finally meets with something other than success there. She'd hit four in a row. Seven points in the game now for Pam. 12:50 to go. 38-33, the Lady Cats leading. Blanton trying to pass inside for Dolman, and Donna Dolman had it knocked away and out of bounds by one of the girls in blue, so it belongs to Western.
Kentucky's shifting very well on their defense now, Denny. They're forcing Western to set up outside much farther.
Beth Blanton put on a good head fake, now launches the shot and hits it with a swish. 9 points for Beth Blanton. She averages 12 per game. Here's Pam Browning spinning for the hoop. Back out, she fans it to Edelman. Grigsby from the side. Good pass into Debbie Oden, and she missed the shot. Rebounded by Timperman. Kentucky will start over again. Linda Edelman with a shot, in and out. Oden going over the back on the rebound. A very obvious foul on Deborah. It's her third.
Denny, Deborah Oden.
Excuse me, Sue. I believe we're going to have to take a timeout now with the score. Kentucky 38, Western 35. Brenda Chapman, the high-scoring guard, is checked back into the game for Western with her team trailing 38-35. Western on the attack in the red uniforms. Beth Blanton out to Karen Frierson, right through her hands and out of bounds. Neither team able to get any momentum going whatsoever, Sue. It just seems as if they've played in spurts tonight. Neither team can get any consistency.
I think so, Denny. I think, of course, maybe last night may have been big games for both teams. Western over Louisville and Kentucky over Moorhead. Big, big games to get to this final.
Pam Browning off to Timperman from the side. Missed it. Mozeth on the rebound. Back up and in. Janine Mozeth, who just checked in at that timeout for Kentucky, was Johnny on the spot there. And Janine has 6 points in the game. She averages only four per game.
Denny, I believe Janine Mozeth came to play today. She looks ready.
That's Donna Dolman forcing up the shot. And Mozeth going over the back of Pam Kortenbrock on the rebound attempt.
Denny,
wait a minute. They called that the other way. And I beg to differ. But
that's very unusual, Denny. Janine looked all over that girl.
And that's the fourth foul also on Kortenbrock, the Western center. This is Janine Mozeth, hacked on the wrist by Kortenbrock, and that'll do it. She's picked up two quick ones and is fouled out.
Denny, she picked that foul up before we could get a substitute in for her.
That's right. Donna Sutton, the six-foot freshman, was waiting at the scorer's table to come in, but before she could, Kortenbrock picked up the fatal foul.
Crucial to Western.
This is Janine Mozeth. Timperman in the corner now. Pam Browning likes that spot. Has it knocked down, no whistle. The ball still alive, and now a foul called on Karen Frierson of Western, her first.
A lot of contact under those boards, Denny, and it's very rugged, and both these teams want this championship very badly. They both want to go on to North Carolina this coming week.
He had a good shot there of Lady Cat Coach Deborah Yao and her fine assistant, Diane Beecher. That's Pam Browning in heavy traffic. Got her own rebound. Lost control of the ball. Kicked by Donna Dolman, and it's going to go over to Kentucky.
Neither team can seem to be getting anything going here, and I think both of them are showing their tiredness.
Linda Edelman with a shot. Bingo!
She hit that one, Denny, just like it's drawn in the picture book. About 18 feet.
42-35, Kentucky leading by seven. 10:40 to go in the game. Donna Dolman with a baseline move. Has a shot slapped back at her, and they say it's touched last. Well, one referee called it one way, and the other called it the other, so we'll probably have a jump ball.
I believe we're going to have a jump. I think Western thought they were fouled there, Denny, but Janine Mozeth goes up a long, long way with those arms. Tremendous reach.
Height advantage here to Kentucky. Dolman is 5'10 for Western. Mozeth 6'2 for the Lady Cats. And it's Janet Timperman with it for the girls in blue. Timperman from the corner. Fight for the rebound. And Mozeth ties up Donna Dolman.
Jenny Timperman's temporarily lost her mark, and of course, as she continues to shoot, I think she'll find her range again, forcing the ball up a little bit.
Kentucky controlling the tap, finally. Knocked out of bounds by Brenda Chapman. There's the big star of the game so far, Brenda Chapman, who came in here after scoring 61 points in the first two tournament games for Western, has scored but three in this one, and she has been shut out in the second half.
Then Kentucky's defense has done an excellent job on her.
To say the least. Foul called on Donna Dolman of Western there as Browning made her move for the hoop.
Last night, Kentucky did the same job on Donna Murphy in the first half, held her to one field goal. And they're doing a trick right now so far in this half.
Pam Browning at the free throw stripe for the Lady Cats. Rebounded by Mozeff. Off to Edelman, now Timperman. One dribble to get a little freer and missed it. This is Beth Blanton for Western off to Karen Frierson. Kentucky in that box and chaser with little Geri Grigsby on Chapman. Now we got a foul called on Pam Browning. That's the second on Pam. Substitution now for Western Kentucky. Checking into the lineup is Sue Rubin, a 5'8 sophomore, number 21, and Donna Dolman goes out.
Western's going to have to give their starting five some rest, Denny. I think this is what they're doing right now. Of course, Corden Brock's already gone out on fouls.
Western has scored only 7 points in the first 10 minutes of the second half. We were tied at halftime, 29-29. Beth Blanton gets to shoot a lot of free throws for Western because she's very active and a good driver. She missed that one. She shot 50 more free throws than any other girl in the Western squad.
Very intense competitor, Denny.
Second, being patient now, a foul call. That one goes against Donna Sutton, her first.
Kentucky's doing a little passing of their own there, Denny.
Here's Debbie Mack checking into the lineup for Kentucky, and Geri Grigsby goes out. So Debbie Mack now will get the assignment against Brenda Chapman in that box and one defense. Let's briefly explain what the box and chaser is for anybody who might not be an avid basketball fan. You simply have four people play a zone in a box configuration, and the other person plays man-to-man on the person that you want to shut off from the opposition. And the person that Kentucky has done such a good job of shutting off tonight has been Brenda Chapman. Janine Mozeff got them both for the Lady Cats. 8 points now for Mozeff. She's doubled her season average. 44-36, Kentucky by eight. 9:20 to go in the game. That's Donna Sutton. Had the shot partially blocked by Mozeff. Browning brought it out of trouble. Now Debbie Mack ahead to Timperman. And she dribbled it out of bounds. They just don't put handles on that thing.
And Kentucky got in a little bit of hurry that time. All they need to do is be patient, come down and set up. You want to score too fast sometimes.
Mozeff playing more good defense and being the greater racer for Kentucky. The rest of the girls can afford to gamble a little bit when Janine is in there with that good reach of hers and rejecting everything.
She certainly can, Denny, and she's been a big factor in Kentucky's success so far.
Debbie Mack had it knocked away from behind, but retrieved it herself. Move, 8:40 to play in the game now. Dangerous pass picked off. Brenda Chapman has it for Western. That's Beth Blanton missing. And a foul on Karen Frierson going over the back of Pam Browning on the rebound attempt. Substitution set to come in at the scorer's table for Kentucky. There's Debbie Oden checking in, number 51, 5'8 sophomore from McRoberts, Kentucky. And Maria Dunoff will be coming in momentarily.
Jenny Beth Blanton, 5'7", had to shoot over 6'2", Janine Mozeff that time, and she didn't quite have a clear view of the basket, I don't think. It's a big basket for Kentucky. Pam Browning, the only senior on this squad, candidate for All-American last year and suffered a very severe ankle injury early in the year. Has gone on to recover from flu and is coming back into her form now. Tournament time.
Browning gets a nice hand as she exits now. Maria Dunoff replacing her. Kentucky's lead is 10 points. That's as big as it's been all night. 46-36, 8:16 to go in the game. Western in red on the attack. Karen Frierson trying to force it inside to Donna Sutton. Has it knocked out of bounds. Western has got to find a way to get some points out of that girl right there, Brenda Chapman. She had 40 in one game earlier this season against Murray. Blanton missing, back up by Rubin, no good. And a good save by Donna Sutton. She saved it back in off the leg of Linda Edelman, but they say too late. She stepped on the paint, so the ball belongs to the Lady Cats. Debbie Mack, 10, and Linda Edelman, rather Debbie Mack, 15, and Linda Edelman, 10, are the guards for the Lady Cats. Brenda Chapman got a hand on that one and knocked it out of bounds. It still belongs to Kentucky. 7:50 to play. 46-36. It was 29-29 at halftime. Mozeth off to Debbie Oden.
Debbie Oden just can't find the bucket tonight. They just won't drop for her.
Not had the eye. Frierson has a pass stolen by Debbie Oden. And a foul called on Debbie.
Well, I'm sure that's going to make Coach Al have add a couple more gray hairs, Denny. She looked like she had position there. Tremendous leaper.
Well, if looks could kill, we'd have a dead official because Debbie Al is just staring darts. Out deep to Beth Blanton. Edelman putting the good defense on her. Now Brenda Chapman. She'll launch the long shot. Hit it. 5 points for Brenda Chapman. She's a 47% shooter from the field. So there's a steal. Brenda Chapman got it off to Blanton. Now Frierson in tight off the glass. Blanton back up. It goes and a chance at a three-pointer. Fouled by Linda Edelman.
Denny, Western's put the press on Kentucky, and before they could get up the floor and the other forwards had gone down, they'd stolen the ball. Three shots at the basket, and they're right back in the ball game. 46-40.
Geri Grigsby coming back in, and Debbie Mack going out. Janet Timperman also re-entering the Kentucky lineup. And Linda Edelman goes out. She definitely wants fresh guards in the game against this press.
Certainly does, and she's getting some ball handlers in there. So I don't think Edelman's been as sharp as she has been all year. She's recovering from the flu.
Blanton missed the free throw, which she doesn't do too often. Kentucky on the attack again, but their lead has been whittled to only half a dozen. 7 minutes to play. Mozeth at the high post to Timperman. Janet Timperman on the move off to Janine Mozeth, and her jumper is perfect. 10 points for Janine Mozeth. And she's been a German Wonder Woman today from Zweibrück in Germany.
Beautiful jump shot there, and timely, too. Kentucky needed to score.
Dragging the pivot foot. A costly turnover on the Western women.
Well, the substitutes have done their job so far. They've got fresh recruits in there and new ball handlers. Kentucky's got the ball again, Denny.
Bad pass by Grigsby, trying to get it inside to Mozeth. Western coming the other way. Beth Blanton with a good pass off to Rubin, but she walked. See, Rubin took a stroll. 6.5 minutes is all that remains. 48-40, Kentucky on top. Now Kentucky getting sloppy with the passes now. Karen Frierson comes up with that one for Western. There's Blanton on the drive. Scoops it up and won't fall. Rebounded by Donna Sutton. Back up and won't go. And a good rebound by Mozeth. Look at the outlet pass. Kentucky on the break. Geri Grigsby. One girl to beat. Has her shot blocked beautifully by Brenda Chapman. You won't see a better defensive play than that.
Great effort by Brenda. I think Geri probably should have used a reverse there and gone on around her, but she didn't. And 5'3" Geri got blocked by 5'6".
There's Pam Browning coming back in for Kentucky and Deborah Oden going out. Western, as expected, wins the tap. Beth Blanton to Karen Frierson.
Kentucky's still in that box and one.
Frierson out on top to Blanton. She'll launch the jumper off the back of the iron. Loose in the lane, the jump ball call between Pam Browning and Donna Sutton.
Jenny, this is not the cleanest ball game we've seen all year. Very rugged out there and not a lot of finesse today.
It's been downright sloppy, as a matter of fact, and this is not the way these two teams normally play. We saw them last night, and both teams played much, much better. There's a reaching in foul, I believe, on Donna Sutton, or perhaps on the jump attempt she jumped into.
Well, anyway, Denny, Kentucky's gotten the ball again, and...
Well, it could not have been a foul.
Probably a jump ball, jump line violation.
Donna Sutton held up her hand, but apparently it was not a foul. That foul is against Karen Frierson, and will send Janet Timperman to the line for Kentucky.
Denny, Kentucky's Geri Grigsby's having a hard time passing that ball around Brenda Chaplin. The last three times she's made bad passes and caused two Kentucky turnovers and almost a third turnover right there. Very ragged play right now.
Janet Timperman has missed her last couple of tries. She's been blanked in the second half after leading Kentucky in scoring in the first 20 minutes. She had 9 before intermission. Now give her 10 for the game. Kentucky's lead is 9 points, 49-40, 5 minutes and 22 seconds to go. Brenda Chapman around the pick, has her shot blocked. Timperman ahead now for Browning. Off to Grigsby. Put on the fake, missed the shot, the foul call on Brenda Chapman.
A good head and body fake.
Yes, it was.
I think Jerry
Grigsby, whose father Pete was a player here at Kentucky.
Yes, he was. Played in the Cliff Hagin days, and I think never thought that Jerry would get a chance to play here or at any place. Then, of course, he's a sensational high school ball player in Kentucky.
Her father was an excellent coach, too, by the way.
One of the first Kentucky girls to ever be named to Parade All-American. And, of course, the other girl sitting on Kentucky's bench tonight, Liz Lookshue, 6'4 and a half center from Owensboro, Kentucky, named to the first Parade All-American girls high school team. They played in New York earlier this spring and decided then to be roommates.
And you're looking at a little girl who's never had anything but A's in school, nothing but A's throughout her academic career. Blanton looking for some help, gets it off to Chapman. She's called for traveling. It's been a nightmarish evening for Brenda Chapman.
It certainly has, Denny. And she's played two excellent games before, and she's just been shut down tonight.
4:50 to go, and there's timeout on the floor with a score. Kentucky 51, Western 40. There's another basketball tournament coming up in Lexington next weekend. It's Wiener King Classic, the second annual Wiener King Classic. It's for the junior pro youngsters. That's next Friday, Saturday, and Sunday at Southern Junior High on Wilsing Downing Road. 16 teams will be competing in that one. So get out and support the junior pro kids. Kentucky on the attack now. Janet Timperman to Maria Dunhoff. Kicked by Brenda Chapman, so it'll be played in front of the Kentucky bench by Dunhoff.
Brenda Chapman playing perhaps her last game of her career. Only been playing basketball for 3 years.
Well, it wouldn't need a can opener to get that one to Janine Mozeff. Kentucky trying hard to force it inside, and too hard. All they need to do is keep it on the perimeter. Now, of course, you've got that 30-second clock in women's basketball. It is a factor also. Got a foul call there on Maria Dunhoff.
Believe her fourth, Denny.
That's right.
Not in position there that time.
Karen Frierson will play this in for Western with 4:23 to go. Out deep to Beth Blanton. That's Frierson, has the shot partially blocked by Mozeff. And she has been a terror tonight.
Denny, I believe she's been the big difference for Kentucky.
There's Linda Edelman, number 10, checking into the lineup for the Lady Cats. And Janet Timperman going out. We're going to have a jump ball between Mozeff and Dolman. Frierson slapping that one back in the face of Browning, but retrieved by the Geri Grigsby. .355 to go now. Western is playing the clock and Kentucky. Offensive foul called there on Pam Browning. She charged into Donna Dolman. The foul on Pam is her third. Timperman back in already for Kentucky, and Browning will go out.
Denny, Kentucky ought to spread things out a little bit defensively. They've got the clock, and they should use it to their advantage. Even though you had 30-second clock, if you spread things out much, that's much better, and stop forcing the inside shot when it's not there.
Here's Brenda Chapman shooting over Geri Grigsby and handed. 7 points for Chapman, and now you're seeing the real Brenda Chapman.
We have a press here now, Denny, by Western.
Geri Grigsby with a good bounce pass to Timperman, who put it in there. Good assist to Grigsby. The basket by Janet Timperman.
Well, Denny, we saw some girls as they look like they ought to look on that particular play.
Nobody could do it better than that particular play. This is Beth Blanton with the jump shot from the wing. Missed it. Frierson on the rebound. And a foul call. Janet Timperman and Frierson together going for the rebound. The foul call on Janet Timperman.
Denny, if I'm not mistaken, I believe I see Pam Corden-Brock back on the court there, and I thought she went out with fouls.
Well, this is the first we've seen of her. Remember, they snuck her back in, but let's go back here and check personal fouls. First half, Corden-Brock 3. Well, they had her down for 3 before the half, and she definitely had 2 quick ones in the second half.
That's what I thought. I thought Corden-Brock had 5 fouls. I thought she went out and was buzzed out on 5.
Karen Frierson at the line for Western. Hit the first one, missed the second, and the ball belongs. Well, it doesn't belong to anybody. They're going to jump it. Referee wasn't sure who touched it last. 10-point advantage for the Lady Cats, 53-43. 3 minutes to go in the game. Geri Grigsby hounded in backcourt. Loses the ball, retrieves it herself, and dribbling, sitting down, she gets away with it.
Denny, I think a couple of people got away with some things there. Kentucky would just spread out here now. Keep their defense spread, and they won't stay in too much.
Linda Edelman open for the jump shot. Western on the rebound, Brenda Chapman. That's Corden-Brock missing the shot. In heavy traffic underneath, Dolman gets it off to Frierson, and she is fouled. Foul on Janine Moseth, and that's the third on Janine.
Janet Timperman's trying to tell the team now, Denny, just slow down. Let's slow down. We've got this. Just take our time and be patient. I think Western's going to give them a run for it. They're only 10 down.
Frierson has missed 2 big free throws in succession now. Make it 3, and Moseth on the rebound. Kentucky coach Deborah Yao shouting, use the clock. 2 minutes and 12 seconds showing on it, with Kentucky on top by 10 points. Janine Moseth with a short jumper, missed it. Rebounded by Donhoff, and she gets the job done. Maria Donhoff with the putback.
She did, Denny, and a big power move underneath. Kentucky needs to score on that one.
That's Corky Corden-Brock from the outside. 13 points for Corden-Brock.
Western's not going to fold, Denny. They're going to take it right down to the wire.
Geri Grigsby on the break. Passing across the lane to Timperman. And they're going to circle the wagon. Martin.
Kentucky showing a lot of patience there, Denny.
.120 is all that remains now. A 3-second violation on the Lady Cats. Janine Moseth spending too much time in the lane. .119 showing on the clock. Kentucky 79 seconds away from its first state women's championship.
We have a timeout here, Denny, I believe.
Moorhead, of course, is
stress fracture, and they have another girl in a cast, Mitzi Combs. with the torn ligament. They're three short in their lineup.
I want to remind you that at 8 p.m. on March the 25th, you can see the finals of the boys' state high school basketball tournament, the Sweet 16, live from Freedom Hall here on Channel 27. That's March the 25th at 8 o'clock, and I hope you'll join Jock Sutherland and I for the call on that one. Another block by Mosette. She crammed it right back down at Pam Kortenbrock, and the crowd goes wild. That should have just about done it.
Denny, I believe that will turn Western in. That was a tremendous block and recovery by Mosette.
Kentucky, under a minute now.
Kentucky spreading them out. I think the fans feel the victory behind us, Denny.
Geri Grigsby on the drive, and we've got a foul called. It's against Brenda Chapman of Western, her third. Pam Browning coming back into the lineup. Janine Mosette will get a tremendous ovation from the fans here.
Denny, she has played a tremendous ball game and to me has been the factor in Kentucky's victory here today. Great future ahead of her and for Kentucky if she stays in this lineup.
Geri Grigsby at the line, averaging 8 points per game this year, has only four so far in this one. She gets the bonus, 5 points for Geri.
Denny, you mentioned earlier about Jerry's four-point average. She's also here on academic scholarship as well as athletic scholarship, as well as Liz Lookshoe, who's in our honors program. Both perfect four-point students.
...57-45, Kentucky by a dozen with only 50 seconds to go. And this one's all over but the shelf. That's Brenda Chapman launching the long jump shot, getting it back and putting it in for Western. Was Donna Dolman. It's 10 points for Donna Dolman. And a foul in backcourt.
Jenny, the fans have started. We're number one in the back, and this is a great victory for Coach Yao and for her troops out there and for Pam Browning, who's never won a state championship and has been to two finals.
Well, Pam Browning with more free throws coming. One thing we didn't get to see much of tonight was the little Mack attack. Debbie Mack was one of the girls that was so impressive when we televised last year, and so many people, we had letters about her for weeks about what an inspiring girl she was to watch play basketball. Debbie's been ill. That's Maria Donoff, the freshman from Louisville, getting the basket. A dozen points for Maria. Only 20 seconds remaining. Pam Kortenbrock running in to Pam Browning. Pam went down. The ball went out of bounds. It belongs to Western.
Denny, you mentioned Deborah Mack. Deborah Mack is, of course, from Lexington Lafayette here, and they call her the Little Mack, and she's been quite ill all week with the flu, been in bed, and hasn't quite been up to her usual self.
Well, they left Dolman wide open for the basket. A dozen points for Donna Dolman, but only 10 seconds left on the clock, 59-49. Donhoff fouled in backcourt. So we walk the other way again with Maria Donhoff to shoot for the Lady Cats, who are about to run their season record to 20-9, 12-3 at home.
Sure, Kentucky fans are behind us, and they're starting the countdown, Denny. It's been a long time coming for Kentucky. I think you're going to see perhaps Pam Browning go out for a last home game here. She had a great career here at Kentucky.
Scored 9 points tonight.
9 points, tremendous stabilizing element in Kentucky's lineup.
Maria Donoff has 13 in this game, looking for 14. She, by the way, had 15 points in the victory over Moorhead last night. A very steady Maria Donoff.
All smiles on Kentucky's faces now.
Brenda Chapman rolled it over. Well, it's been that kind of a night for the Western Lady Toppers and Brenda Chapman.
Yes, it has, Denny. I think we might still see Brenda Chapman make the all-tournament team. She's had two great games.
Geri Grigsby had the pass blocked out of bounds as the clock ran out. The final score is Kentucky 61, Western Kentucky 49. We'll be back at courtside after this message.
When it's your turn to make the
Kentucky Lady Cats cutting down the net. They have just given Lady Cat coach Deborah Yao a triumphant ride around the court on their shoulders. Kentucky has beaten Western for the championship of the Kentucky Women's Intercollegiate Tournament 61-49. And briefly, we'll run down the all-tournament team for you. We will not have time to stay around and see the girls being presented. So the all-tournament team is Debbie Ames of Moorhead, Beth Blanton of Western, Maria Donhoff of University of Kentucky, Brenda Chapman from Western, Peggy Gay of Eastern Kentucky, Jackie Mounts of Murray, Donna Murphy from Moorhead, Debbie Oden from Kentucky, Valerie Owens of Louisville, and Peggy Vincent from Northern Kentucky. We'll return to Memorial Coliseum in Lexington after these messages. Winner over Western, 61-49. Sue Feimster, it was not beauty, but I don't imagine Coach Deborah Yao is going to forfeit for lack of artistic merit.
I don't think so, Denny. A win is a win is a win. And, of course, Kentucky will go on to represent the state in the Region 2 Southern Championship next week. University of North Carolina, their first-round opponent will be East Carolina State, the second team to finish the North Carolina State Championship. And they will be playing Thursday afternoon. It will be carried by WBKY. And we hope that everyone has enjoyed their telecast today.
Three Lady Cats in double figures, Maria Donhoff with 14, Janet Timperman with 12, and Janine Mosef with 10. The final score again, Kentucky 61 and Western 49. For Sue Feimster and our entire crew, this is Denny Treese saying thanks for watching.
Live from Memorial Coliseum in Lexington, Kentucky, WKYT Sports has presented the Kentucky Women's College Basketball Championship. Tonight's game was brought to you in part by Leroy's Jewelers, seven stores in the Bluegrass area.